Hi, I'm Chris Edwards. Welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week, we're gonna look at rackets that are gonna give you great power and spin on your shots. And there's a specific kind of a spec out there that's really gonna help you get there and really maximize the power and spin potential of your game. Now, first up, I've got a really, really popular racket, and this is the Babolat Aero Pro Drive. And I actually have the plus length version in my hands right now. And the reason why I grabbed the plus length version of this racket is because it is a half inch longer racket, when I swing it, the tip of the racket, because it's further away from my hand, is gonna be traveling that little bit faster, and you're gonna be able to turn that tip speed into added pace on your shots and also added spin. So the faster you swing, the faster you can spin the ball. And so all the rackets we're gonna look at really gonna encourage you to take a big cut of the ball and get maximum spin on it. And you can turn that long, fast swing also into a lot of pace and power. Now this racket is also designed to cut through the air very quickly. It's nice and lightweight. It's very maneuverable, just really fast, easy racket to swing. It also has a nice round-ish head shape to it too. So you can really attack the ball at a very aggressive angle. Make sure that you clear both the leading edge and the trailing edge of the frame and really just nick that ball and really just brush against it to get it really rotating. And you can take that very aggressive angle swing with this one and get a lot of spin out of it. And I like the plus length version just because I get that little bit extra kick on all of my shots. Now, another great option to go with would be this Volkl Super G8. And this is the 300 gram version. Also comes in a slightly heavier version too if you want something a bit beefier. And I like this one because it offers a bit more feel too. I get that same great spin potential. Again, very nice 16-19 string pattern, really nice openness to the hoop of the racket, so I can really attack that ball with an aggressive swing. But I get a little bit more feel and control out of this one just from the grommet system and the frame design of this one. So it really does encourage me to stay aggressive even when I'm transitioning into the court, maybe attacking the net. I can really cut through aggressively with this racket. I don't fear overhitting with it. And so it's a really good racket for encouraging you to really swing aggressive. So that's another great option right there. That one's from Volkl. And then we just wrapped up our playtest of the new Extreme rackets. There's Graphene XT Extremes from Head. And this one here was really what gave me the idea for this vlog. It was really inspiration was, this is a great racket. This is the Extreme Pro Graphene XT. And it is just a great racket for the intermediate through advanced level player really looking to hit with a ton of spin and really get some good power on their shots. Again, it's got good feel from the string bed. It's got that really openness to the hoop design, so you can really attack aggressively. It's the pro version, so it's got a bit more weight to it than the standard Extreme Mid Plus, or the MPA as it's now being called, with its variable string pattern. And it just really does encourage you to take a nice healthy cut of the ball. And all of our playtesters were loving the spin they were getting out of this. We've been stringing all these rackets with a poly. And if you have a healthy arm and you're taking a good rip of the ball, you're finding the sweet spot most of the time. Poly is a really good string option, but it is stiffer. It's not a comfortable string. So if you're using a firmer beam racket like one of these and you're shanking it a lot, you're getting near the edge of the frame a lot, or you're not taking that big rip at the ball all the time, you're really not going to maximize the benefits of a poly. So you're probably going to want to look at a hybrid or a softer string option like a multifilament, and you'll still get great spin and great power out of all these rackets. You'll get even more power actually if you string it with a multi, or even go a step further and go with a natural gut. Now, last but not least, I've got a couple of Wilsons in my hands, and these are a couple of different blades, and there's different ways you can go too. These rackets offer a little bit more control, but that controlled aspect to them is going to encourage you to supply the power. So you're going to be swinging very fast and you're going to get a lot of spin out of these two. I just have the 1820 with me right now, and then I have the 98S, which has that spin effect 1816 pattern in it, which is designed to offer maximum spin. So if you really want something that's going to grab the ball and spit it out with a lot of spin, it also is going to increase the launch angle out of the racket a little bit, so you're going to get some higher net clearance, and then the spin's going to help the ball drop inside the court. 98S is a great way to go. But my favorite actually of the three blades that are out there in the 98 head size is the 1820, which I'm holding now, because it has a very dense string pattern combined with the more control-oriented beam design you see in the blade, or something like a Pure Strike, or maybe a Volkl in the 9 or 10 series, etc. It's going to offer a lot more control, and that's going to allow me to swing very aggressively without fear of overhitting. And that's really how you're going to maximize the power and spin potential that's in your game. So you're going to use a racket that's going to give you the most confidence to go after that shot every single time. And with the dense 18-20 string pattern, yeah, the string pattern itself isn't inherently going to give me more spin because it's so dense, the strings aren't going to be moving around as much and snapping back. But because it's so control-oriented, it gives me the confidence to take a really healthy cut at the ball and maximize the spin I'm going to be able to get with my style of swing. If you are a more modern player than me and you're really already taking a really aggressive cut at the ball and using more of a Western-style grip, then an open string pattern might be a better way to go. But if you have a bit more of a classic game, 18-20 can really give you that confidence you need to swing through and maximize the way you get spin on the ball. So there's a few different options out there. I suggest you get out there, do some demoing. Summer months are here, plenty of great tennis weather. Get out there, have a good time, try and add some spin and power to your game. I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching.